This is your weather radio station WXK87 in Clinton, operating on a frequency of 162.525 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman, Oklahoma. You're listening to Clinton Weather Radio, and here are noon observations. At Clinton, it was partly cloudy. The temperature was 75 degrees, the dew point was 61, with a relative humidity of 62%. The wind was east-northeast at 6 miles per hour. The pressure was 29.89 inches and rising. Observations from around the region. It was partly cloudy, with a temperature of 74 at Oklahoma City, 75 at Norman, 72 at Enid, and 71 at Lawton. It was mostly sunny, with a temperature of 77 at Wichita Falls, 76 at Childress, 75 at Amarillo, 79 at Dallas-Fort Worth, and 77 at Denver. Once again at Clinton, it was partly cloudy. The temperature was 75. The following is your hazardous weather outlook. This hazardous weather outlook is for northern, western, central, and southern Oklahoma, and western North Texas. Day 1, today and tonight, thunderstorms. There is an extreme risk of severe weather across Oklahoma and western North Texas. All modes of severe weather will exist throughout the early morning through late evening, with destructive winds, large destructive hail, and long track tornadoes across the area. The earliest time frame for thunderstorm coverage is expected to begin at around 11 a.m. as an area of low pressure located in Colorado is expected to move to the east at a rapid rate. Flooding, there is a high risk of flash flooding across the coverage area from late this morning through the early evening hours, with a potential for 2 to 3 inches, with isolated amounts of 4 to 5 inches of rainfall in areas along Apopka City to Stillwater to Ada to Durant Line. Days 2 through 7, Tuesday through Sunday, thunderstorms. There is a potential for severe thunderstorms to linger into the overnight hours Tuesday morning, before exiting the coverage area entirely in the early morning hours. Get graphics and more details at weather.gov/Norman, and follow our weather forecast office on Facebook and on Twitter. From the Norman Forecast Office, here is the forecast for Clinton and the surrounding area. Today, showers. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties: in Oklahoma, Beckham, Blaine, Caddo, Custer, Dewey, Kiowa, Roger Mills, and Wichita. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions, and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the latest severe weather information. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties: in Oklahoma, Beckham, Blaine, Caddo, Custer, Dewey, Kiowa.
Thank you.
your thunderstorm watch number 108, effective until 9 p.m. Mountain Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties in New Mexico: Bernalillo, Sandoval, and Valencia. Remember, a severe thunderstorm watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions, and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the latest severe weather information. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties in Texas: Bailey, Castro, Deaf Smith, Lamb, Oldham, Palmer, and Randall. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail, and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions, and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the latest severe weather information. The National Weather Service has issued Severe Thunderstorm Watch number 108, effective until 9 p.m. Mountain Daylight Time. This watch includes the following county: Curry Man, New Mexico. Remember, a severe thunderstorm watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions, and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the... The National Weather Service in Albuquerque has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southeastern Curry Man County in east-central New Mexico, northern Roosevelt County in east-central New Mexico, until 11:30 a.m. Mountain Daylight Time. At 11:02 a.m. Mountain Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located 9 miles east of Tabun, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Hazard: 60 mile per hour wind gusts and quarter-size hail. Source: radar indicated. Impact: hail damage to vehicles is expected. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Clovis, Cannon Air Force Base, Melrose Air Force Range, and Portales. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a building. The National Weather Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southwestern Palmer County in northwestern Texas, northwestern Bailey County in northwestern Texas, until 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:02 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located 9 miles east of Tabun, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Hazard: 60 mile per hour wind gusts and quarter-size hail. Source: radar indicated. Impact: hail damage to vehicles is expected. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Farwell. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a building. The National Weather Service in Albuquerque has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southeastern Curry Man County in east central New Mexico, northern Roosevelt County in east central New Mexico, until 11:30 a.m. Are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly National Weather Service in Norman has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, southern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, until 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:11 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located 4 miles southeast of Dempsey, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Expected hazards include 70 miles per hour wind gusts and half-dollar size hail. This is a radar-indicated threat. The following impacts are expected. Hail damage to vehicles is expected. Expect considerable tree damage. Wind damage is also likely to mobile homes, roofs, and outbuildings. Locations impacted include Sweetwater, Dempsey, Grimes, Mayfield, and Elk City. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a building. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, southern Roger Mills County. Thunderstorm warning for northern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, southern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, until 12:45. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, southern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, until 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:13 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located 6 miles southeast of Dempsey, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a tornado and half-dollar size hail. This is a radar-indicated threat rotation. The following impacts are expected. Flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. Locations impacted include Sweetwater, Dempsey, Grimes, Mayfield, and Elk City. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, southern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, until 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:13 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing You're listening to NOAA Weather Radio Station, WXK79, the voice of the National Weather Service in Lubbock. This broadcast serves the south central plains of Texas. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties: in Texas, Cochran, Crosby, Floyd, Garza, Hale, Hockley, Lamb, Lubbock, Lynn, and Terry. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail, and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the latest. Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southwestern Lubbock County in northwestern Texas, eastern Cochran County in northwestern Texas, southern Hockley County in northwestern Texas, until 1 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:14 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located near sundown, or 9 miles southwest of Llewellyn, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Hazard, 60 miles per hour wind gusts and quarter-size hail. Source, radar indicated. Impact, hail damage to vehicles is expected. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Lubbock, Llewellyn, Woolforth, Shallow Water, Sundown, Recenter, Smyre, Whiteface, and Opdyke West. A tornado watch remains in effect for the area. Tornadoes can develop quickly from severe thunderstorms. Although a tornado is not immediately likely, if one is spotted, act quickly and move to a place of safety in a sturdy structure, such as a basement or small interior room. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southeastern Castro County in the panhandle of Texas, northwestern Hale County in northwestern Texas, southwestern Swisher County in the panhandle of Texas, northeastern Lamb County in northwestern Texas, until 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:18 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located 7 miles southwest of Hart, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Hazard, 60 miles per hour wind gusts and ping pong ball size hail. Source, radar indicated. Impact, people and animals outdoors will be injured. Expect hail damage to roofs, siding, windows, and vehicles. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Plainview, Hart, Cress, Edmondson, and Spring Lake. A tornado watch remains in effect for the area. Tornadoes can develop quickly from severe thunderstorms. Although a tornado is not immediately likely, if one is spotted, act quickly and move to a place of safety in a sturdy structure, such as a basement or small interior room. For your protection, move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. The National Weather Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southeastern Castro County in the panhandle of Texas, northwestern Hale County in northwestern... Eastern Castro County in the panhandle of Texas, northwestern Hale County in... The National Weather Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Lubbock County in northwestern Texas, southeastern Hockley County in northwestern Texas, until 1 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:19 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located 9 miles northeast of Lockettville, or 9 miles southeast of Leveland, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Hazard: damaging tornado and ping pong ball size hail. Source: emergency management confirmed tornado. At 12:17 p.m., multiple reports of a tornado touchdown were received about 5 miles southeast of Leveland. Impact: flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. The tornado will be near Woolforth, Lubbock South Plains Mall and Reese Center around 1 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Smyer, Ropesville and Lubbock Science Spectrum. To repeat, a tornado is on the ground. Take cover now. Move to a basement or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Lubbock County in northwestern Texas, southeastern Hockley County in northwestern Texas, until 1 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:19 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located 9 miles northeast of Lockettville, or 9 miles southeast of Leveland, moving east at 30. Miles per hour. Hazard: damaging tornado and ping pong ball size hail. Source: emergency management confirmed tornado. At 12. Particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard: deadly tornado and $0.5 size hail. Source: local law enforcement reported tornado. Local law enforcement in Lubbock County have reported a large tornado bearing down on western Lubbock. In addition, power flashes have been observed in the city of Woolforth. Impact: you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near Texas Tech University now. Downtown Lubbock around 12:50 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Lubbock International Airport around 1:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Idaloo and Ransom Canyon around 1:10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Lubbock Science Spectrum. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado. National Weather Service in Lubbock, Texas has issued a tornado warning for central Lubbock County in northwestern Texas, southwestern Crosby County in northwestern Texas, until 1:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 12:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was observed over Lubbock South Plains Mall, or near Lubbock, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for downtown Lubbock. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado and half dollar size hail. Source, local law enforcement reported tornado. Local law enforcement in Lubbock County have reported a large tornado bearing down on western Lubbock. In addition, power flashes have been observed in the city of Woolforth. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near Texas Tech University now. Downtown Lubbock around 12:50 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Lubbock International Airport around 1:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Idaloo and Ransom Canyon around 1:10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Lubbock Science Spectrum. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid. This is your weather radio station WXK31 in Wichita Falls, operating on a frequency of 162.475 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman, Oklahoma. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties in Oklahoma, Cotton and Tillman, and the following counties in Texas, Archer, Baylor, Clay, Wichita, and Wilbarger. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions, and should listen for later statements or possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets or internet sources for the latest severe weather in... The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for West Central Clay County in northern Texas, Northern Archer County in northern Texas, Southern Wichita County in northern Texas, Southeastern Wilbarger County in northern Texas, Northeastern Baylor County in northern Texas, until 1:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:09 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located near Lake Diversion, or 23 miles southwest of Burke Burnett, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Severe weather has been confirmed by Emergency Management confirmed tornado. The following impacts are expected. Flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. Locations impacted include Wichita Falls, Iowa Park, Holiday, Dean, Shepherd AFB, Northeastern Lake Diversion, Lakeside City, Pleasant Valley, and Cashin. To repeat, a tornado is on the ground. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for West Central Clay County in Northern Texas, Northern Archer County in Northern Texas, Southern Wichita County in Northern Texas, Southeastern Wilberger County in A confirmed tornado was located near Lake Diversion, or 23 miles southwest of Burke Burnett. Move the tornado warning for northeastern Baylor and southeastern Wichita counties is canceled. The storm which prompted the warning has moved out of the warned area. Therefore, the warning has been canceled. A tornado watch remains in effect until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time Monday evening for central Oklahoma and northern Texas. A tornado warning remains in effect until 1:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for West Central Clay, Northeastern Archer and Southeastern Wichita counties. At 1:19 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located near Holiday, or 13 miles west of Wichita Falls, moving east at 30 miles per hour. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, damaging tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Source, emergency management confirmed tornado. Power flashes and scoured roadways have been reported in Kamei. At 1:17 p.m., a large tornado was reported crossing Texas Route 258, slowly moving east. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Wichita Falls, Iowa Park, Holiday, Dean, Jolly, Shepherd AFB, Mankins, Lakeside City, and Pleasant Valley. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. This is your weather radio station WXK31 in Wichita Falls, operating on a frequency of 162.475 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman, Oklahoma. The tornado warning for northeastern Baylor and southeastern Wichita counties is canceled. The storm which prompted the warning has moved out of the warned area. Therefore, the warning has been canceled. A tornado watch remains in effect until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time Monday evening for central Oklahoma and northern Texas. A tornado warning remains in effect until 1:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for West Central Clay, Northeastern Archer and Southeastern Wichita counties. At 1:19 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located near Holiday, or 13 miles west of Wichita Falls. PM Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was tornado emergency for Wichita Falls. A tornado warning remains in effect until 1:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for West Central Clay, Northeastern Archer and Southeastern Wichita counties. At 1:29 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a large and extremely dangerous tornado was observed over southwestern Wichita Falls, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Wichita Falls. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado and hail up to baseball size. Source, storm spotters and emergency management confirmed large tornado paralleling U.S. Route 277 near Wichita Falls. In addition, at 1:28 p.m., large swaths of debris from collapsed foundations were reported to be blocking roadways and underground shelters in Kamei. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Wichita Falls, Iowa Park, Holiday, Dean, Jolly, Shepherd AFB, Mankins, Lakeside City, and Pleasant Valley. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself. This NOAA weather radio station is temporarily off the air. Please tune to an alternate weather radio broadcast or visit weather.gov for the latest weather information. This NOAA weather radio station is temporarily off the air. Please tune to an alternate weather radio broadcast or visit weather.gov for the latest weather information. This NOAA weather radio station is temporarily off the air.
You're listening to KWEY Coyote Country. I am Alex Matthews. We usually aren't a news station, but we have received concerns involving damage reports from the south end of Clinton, along with reports of trees uprooted and debris lofted as far east as the southeastern edge of Custer County. These reports are indicative of a possible tornado that was rain-wrapped earlier in the day, but it is of no surprise, however, as this was something that the National Weather Service had anticipated 7 days in advance as well. There are already warnings for our south and west, as storms are forecast to enter the coverage area around 2 o'clock to 2:30 p.m. Speaking of, we do have a tornado warning cell approaching southwestern Roger Mills and northwestern Beckham counties, so don't be surprised if a tornado warning gets issued for that area not too long afterwards. Wait a minute. It looks like they're going to go ahead. Confirmation of a tornado touchdown near the Texas-Oklahoma state line. Regardless, this does not mean that the threat has subsided in any way, shape, or form, as a tornado is confirmed on the ground doing damage. If you are in the polygon, You do not need to wait. A tornado is on the ground, and you need to seek shelter immediately. If any more warnings come through the air here, we will break into programming when necessary. You are listening to KWEY Coyote Country. Stay tuned for further coverage.
Sweet water and MC. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris.
This is NOAA Weather Radio Station WXK87 in Clinton, operating on the frequency of 162.525 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman.
The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch number 109, effective until 10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties: in Oklahoma, Beckham, Blaine, Caddo, Custer, Dewey, Kiowa, Roger. National Weather Service in Norman has issued a flash flood warning for southwestern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, northwestern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, until 4:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:43 p.m. Central Daylight Time, Doppler radar indicated thunderstorms producing heavy rain across the warned area. Flash flooding is expected to begin shortly. Some locations that will experience flooding include Sweetwater and Dempsey. Turn around, dog drown when encountering flooded roads. Most flood deaths occur in vehicles. Move to higher ground now. Act quickly to protect your life. Weather Service in Norman has issued a flash flood warning for eastern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, Grady County in central Oklahoma, Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma, Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, northeastern Kiowa County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Custer County in western Oklahoma, Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, southwestern Blaine County in northwestern Oklahoma, Canadian County in central Oklahoma, McLean County in central Oklahoma, until 5:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:44 p.m. Central Daylight Time, gauge reports indicated heavy rainfall occurring along an area from east of Clinton to west of Tribby, with isolated reports of flash flooding in the Oklahoma City metro. A growing concern exists for the potential for further flash flooding as thunderstorms train across the area. Up to 1 inch of rain has already fallen, with isolated amounts of 2 inches in Oklahoma City and more. Flash flooding is already occurring. Some locations that will experience flooding include Oklahoma City, Norman, Edmond, Moore, Midwest City, Del City, El Reno, Chickasha, Weatherford, Newcastle, Blanchard, Anadarko, Purcell, Yukon, Bethany, Mustang, Choctaw, War Acres, The Village and Noble. Turn around, dog drown when encountering flooded roads. Most flood deaths occur in vehicles. Move to higher ground now. Act quickly to protect your life. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a flash flood warning for eastern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, Grady County in central Oklahoma, Caddo County in South. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-27 in Tulsa. These broadcasts originate from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Tulsa. Transmitting facilities are located in Northeast Oklahoma and serve metropolitan Tulsa and surrounding areas. And now the hazardous weather outlook. Issued at 11:54 a.m. Central Daylight Time. This outlook is for Northwest and West Central Arkansas as well as much of Eastern Oklahoma. Day 1, through tonight. Tornado. Risk, extreme in eastern Oklahoma, high in northwestern Arkansas. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. Severe thunderstorm. Risk, extreme in eastern Oklahoma, high in northwestern Arkansas. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. Flash flood. Risk, significant. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. River flood. Risk, significant. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. Heavy rain. Risk, significant. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. Significant wind. Risk, significant. Area, eastern Oklahoma and northwestern Arkansas. Onset, from 3 p.m. to around 2 a.m. Discussion, an area of low pressure along with unusually warm spring-like temperatures have given way to conditions deemed exceptionally favorable for severe thunderstorms with the capability to produce flash flooding, damaging wind gusts up to hurricane force, large hail up to grapefruit size, and long-track, violent tornadoes across the coverage area. The time frame for severe weather to enter the coverage area appears to be from around 3 p.m., with thunderstorms forecast to exit the coverage area by 2 a.m. overnight. These threats are forecast to occur in the greatest risk area west of the Oklahoma-Arkansas state line, with the threat diminishing gradually as severe thunderstorms push into Arkansas overnight. This has opened up the potential for an extremely dangerous, unprecedented, and potentially life-threatening severe weather event across eastern Oklahoma as storms unfold across the area throughout the afternoon hours into the overnight. Severe weather watches and warnings are anticipated, with activation of spotter networks and severe weather safety plans also expected. All preparations should be in place before severe weather begins to threaten later today. Spotter and Emergency Management Action Statement, activation of the regional spotter network expected. And now the extended outlook for Tuesday through Sunday. Tuesday, thunderstorm potential, high wind potential. Wednesday and Thursday, no hazards. Friday, high wind potential. Saturday and Sunday, no hazards. Extended discussion. Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch Number 110, in effect until midnight Central Daylight Time, this evening. This watch includes the following counties in the listening area. In Arkansas, Benton, Carroll, Crawford, Franklin, Logan, Madison, Scott, Sebastian and Washington. In Missouri, Barry and McDonald. In Oklahoma, Adair, Atoka, Bryan, Cherokee, Choctaw, Cole, Craig, Creek, Delaware, Haskell, Hughes, Kay, Latimer, LaFleur, Mays, McIntosh, Muskogee, Noble, Nuada, Okfusgee, Okmulgee, Osage, Ottawa, Pawnee, Payne, Pittsburgh, Pushmataha, Rogers, Seminole, Sequoia, Tulsa, Wagoner, and Washington. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Remember, a tornado watch means that conditions are favorable for severe weather in or close to the watch area. Persons in these areas should be alert for threatening weather conditions and listen for later statements and possible warnings. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch Number 110 in effect until midnight Central Daylight Time this evening. This watch includes the following counties in the listening area. In Arkansas. At 1:44 p.m. Central Daylight Time, gauge reports indicated heavy rainfall occurring along an area from east of Clinton to west of Tribune, with isolated reports of flash flooding in the Oklahoma City metro. A growing concern exists for the potential for further flash flooding as thunderstorms train across the area. Up to 1 inch of rain has already fallen, with isolated amounts of... National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northern Jackson County in southwestern Oklahoma, northwestern Kiowa County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Greer County in southwestern Oklahoma, until 2:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:49 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located near Granite, or near Mangum, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a tornado and baseball-sized hail. This is a radar-indicated threat rotation. The following impacts are expected. Flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. Locations impacted include Hobart, Granite, Lone Wolf, Roosevelt, and Altus Lugard Lake. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northern Jackson County in southwestern Oklahoma, northwestern Kiowa County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Greer County in southwestern Oklahoma. You're listening to NOAA, All Hazards, the voice of the National Weather Service, station WNG651, serving the Mineral Wells listening area. The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch Number 110, effective until midnight Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties, in Texas, Erath, Hood, Jackson, Palo Pinto, Parker, Stevens, Turret, Wise, and Young. This is a particularly dangerous situation. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for western Young County in north central Texas, western Eastland County in north central Texas, western Stevens County in north central Texas, until 2:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:58 p.m. Central Daylight Time, severe thunderstorms were located along a line extending from 8 miles east of Irby to 6 miles north, until 2:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 1:58 p.m. Central Daylight Time, severe thunderstorms were located along a line extending from 8 miles east of Irby to 6 miles north of Rodin, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Hazard, 60 miles per hour wind gusts and half-dollar size hail. Source, radar indicated. Impact, hail damage to vehicles is possible. Expect wind damage to roofs, siding, and trees. Locations impacted include Breckenridge, Eastland, Cisco, Kinsight, Crystal Falls, Elbert, and I-20 near the Callahan-Eastland County line. For your protection, stay inside a sturdy structure and keep away from windows. The normal broadcast schedule has been suspended because warnings have recently been issued for parts of your listening area. These warnings and statements will play next. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for western Young County and north central Texas, western Eastland County and north central Texas, western Stevens County and north... At 1:49 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located near Granite, or near Mangum, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a tornado and baseball-sized hail. This is a radar-indicated threat route. National Weather Service in Norman has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northeastern Jackson County in southwestern Oklahoma, southwestern Kiowa County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Greer County in southwestern Oklahoma, until 2:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:12 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm was located near Blair, or 8 miles north of Altus, moving east at 30 miles per hour. This is a very dangerous storm. Expected hazards include 70 miles per hour wind gusts and hail 2 inches in diameter. Severe weather has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. 2-inch hail was reported near Blair at 2:10 p.m. The following impacts are expected. People and animals outdoors will be injured. Expect considerable tree damage. Wind damage is also likely to mobile homes, roofs, and outbuildings. Locations impacted include Altus, Blair, Mountain Park, Roosevelt, Friendship, Altus Air Force Base, Warren and Tom Steed Reservoir. A tornado watch remains in effect for the area. Although a tornado is not immediately likely, if one is spotted, act quickly and move to a place of safety in a sturdy structure, such as a basement or small interior room. Prepare immediately for large destructive hail capable of producing significant damage. People outside should move to a shelter, preferably inside a strong building and away from windows. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for northeastern Jackson County in southwestern Oklahoma, southwestern Kiowa County in southwestern Oklahoma.
This is NOAA Weather Radio Station WXK85 in Oklahoma City, operating on a frequency of 162.400 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman.
The National Weather Service has issued Tornado Watch Number 110, effective until midnight Central Daylight Time. This watch includes the following counties: in Oklahoma, Canadian, Cleveland, Grady, Kingfisher, Logan, McLean, Oklahoma, Payne, and Pottawatomie. This is a particularly dangerous situation. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Comanche County in southwestern Oklahoma, southwestern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma, until 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:26 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located over Fletcher, or 16 miles south of Anadarko, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado. Tornadic debris has been confirmed by radar. The following impacts are expected. Flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. Locations impacted include Elgin, Apache, Rush Springs, Fletcher, Cyril, Sterling, Cement, Agawam, Eastern Lake Ellsworth, Northeastern Fort Sill, Nanaka, and Acme. To repeat, a tornado is on the ground. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Comanche County in southwestern Oklahoma, southwestern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Caddo County in southwest. Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma until 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:26 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located over Fletcher, or 16 miles south. National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northwestern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, southeastern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, southwestern Custer County in western Oklahoma, northeastern Beckham County in western Oklahoma, until 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:28 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located over Canute, or near Elk City, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Severe weather has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. The following impacts are expected. Flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. Locations impacted include Elk City, Clinton, Burns Flat, Arapahoe, Canute, Bessie, Foss Reservoir, and Stafford. To repeat, a tornado is on the ground. Take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northwestern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, southeastern Roger Mills County in western Oklahoma, southwestern. At 2:28 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located over Canute, or near Elk City, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and hail 2 inches in. National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, northwestern Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Custer County in western Oklahoma, southwestern Blaine County in northwestern Oklahoma, until 3:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:39 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located near Clinton, moving east at 30 miles per hour. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Severe weather has been confirmed by local law enforcement. At 2:37 p.m., power flashes and scoured roadways were reported in Elk City. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely, and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Weatherford, Clinton, Hydro, and Arapahoe. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Wichita County in western Oklahoma, northwestern Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma, southeastern Custer. The following is a preliminary storm report. A touchdown of a tornado was reported near the Eastman-Erath County line. The normal broadcast schedule has been suspended because warnings have recently been issued for parts of your listening area. These warnings and statements will play next. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a severe thunderstorm warning for southwestern Montague County in north central Texas, eastern Young County in north central Texas, northern Hamilton County in north central Texas, Erath County in north central Texas, northeastern Eastland County in north central Texas, Jack County in north central. National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for Somerville County in north central Texas, east central Erath County in north central Texas, northwestern Ross County in north central Texas, southern Hood County in north central Texas, until 3:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:40 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located near Stephenville, moving east at 30 miles per hour. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard: damaging tornado. Source: radar and storm spotters confirm tornado touchdown near the Eastman-Erath County line. In addition, power flashes have been observed due west of Stephensville. Impact: you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely, and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near Glen Rose and Dinosaur Valley State Park around 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter now. Get to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building and avoid windows. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Parker County in north central Texas, east central Palo Pinto County in north central Texas, until 3:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:44 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm capable of producing a tornado was located near Mineral Wells, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Hazard: tornado and hail 3 inches in diameter. Source: radar indicated rotation. Impact: flying debris may be dangerous to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be damaged or destroyed. Damage to roofs, windows, and vehicles will occur. Tree damage is likely. This dangerous storm will be near Cool and Mineral Wells State Park around 3:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Millsap. Take cover now. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter now. Get to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building and avoid windows. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Parker County in north central Texas, east central Palo Pinto County in north central Texas, until 3:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:44 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a severe thunderstorm came. Southeastern Caddo County in southwestern Oklahoma until 3 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:26 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed tornado was located over Fletcher, or 16 miles south of Anadarko, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Expected hazards included tornado emergency for El Reno, northern Oklahoma City, Bethany, Yukon, Richland, and Edmond. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for western Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Canadian County in central Oklahoma, until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 2:59 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado was observed over El Reno, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for El Reno, northern Oklahoma City, Bethany, Yukon, Richland, and Edmond. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Those in the emergency area should not delay. Take cover now. Expected hazards include an extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado. A tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. At 2:55 p.m., a trained spotter reported a large tornado crossing Interstate 40, slowly moving eastward. At 2:57 p.m., a mobile Doppler radar site near El Reno reported wind speeds of over 295 miles per hour in association with the tornado. Casualties, collapsed foundations, and scoured roadways have been reported in Clinton. On the present path, this extremely dangerous tornado will cause mass devastation to the northern sections of Oklahoma City. Those in Oklahoma City and in areas in the northern metro should immediately seek shelter now. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Oklahoma City, southwestern Edmond, Del City, El Reno, Yukon, Bethany, War Acres, The Village, Piedmont, Nichols Hills, Concho, Forest Park, Woodlawn Park, Lake Aluma, Smith Village, Richland, the Capitol, Wiley Post Airport, the Fairgrounds, and downtown Edmond. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. This tornado has the potential to cause mass devastation and loss of life in the emergency area. Mobile homes and buildings above ground will not offer any protection from this violent tornado, as there are reports of foundations completely scoured and defoliated in Clinton and Weatherford. Seek an underground shelter immediately. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Thank you. emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, northern Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Canadian County in central Oklahoma, northwestern McLean County in central Oklahoma, until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 3:01 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado with a history of cataclysmic damage was observed near Tuttle, or 10 miles northwest of Newcastle, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Seek an underground shelter immediately. Expected hazards include an extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado. A tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. At 2:54 p.m., a mobile Doppler radar site near Minco estimated wind speeds to be greater than 300 miles per hour before being knocked offline by the tornado. At 2:58 p.m., numerous reports of power poles snapped, areas of large debris blocking roadways, and extensive power outages were reported in Minco. Injuries, fatalities, and scoured foundations have been reported in Minco, Tuttle, and Grace Mont, with an extended history of damage as far west as Carnegie. In addition, another tornado with its own history of catastrophic to apocalyptic devastation is on a direct path towards Oklahoma City, prompting a tornado emergency for the northern portion of the metro. Residents in the Oklahoma City metro, regardless of where you are, should immediately seek an underground shelter. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include southern Oklahoma City, Norman, Moore, Midwest City, Dell City, Newcastle, Mustang, Choctaw, Tuttle, Macoma Park, Valley Brook, Bridge Creek, Tinker Air Force Base, Stanley Draper Lake, Lake Thunderbird, Smith Village and Will Rogers Airport. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. This tornado has the potential to cause mass devastation and loss of life in the emergency area, as there are reports of buildings suffering total collapse or complete defoliation in Minco and Tuttle. Do not delay, take action now to protect your life. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation.
You are currently listening to KOKC. I am Glenn Rogers. We have had to cut into programming here because of warnings that were issued by the National Weather Service not too long ago. And the wording in these warnings are, need I say, rather dire. Especially since these are locations that have been hit by violent tornadoes in the past. Trained weather spotters have confirmed two large wedge tornadoes. One tracking towards the northern half of Oklahoma City, and a second tracking towards southern Oklahoma City and more. This has prompted Norman to issue a tornado emergency for Oklahoma City and the surrounding metro. An explicitly worded preparedness section has indicated that these tornadoes have the potential to cause not only mass devastation, but loss of life as well. If you value your life, the best option at the present moment is to seek an underground shelter, as there are confirmed reports of buildings suffering total collapse, with buildings being completely defoliated as a result of these monstrous tornadoes. Charles, what's coming through the wire?
Glenn, I'm seeing worlds that I've not even seen in a warning bulletin before. The weather service isn't just calling this cataclysmic, but this warning indicators of almost certain death if you're not underground.
Oh, good heavens. Ladies and gentlemen, one of, if not the worst case scenario, may be unfolding in front of our own eyes. We have already received confirmation of damage that can only be described as out of the ordinary. If you are anywhere in Edmond, Oklahoma City, Moore, the Village, Stanley Draper Lake, Bethany, do not delay and seek an underground shelter now. Sirens are already sounding here in downtown Oklahoma City. Looking at the radar at the moment, a large debris signature was located just over Bethany, with a second debris signature not too far behind it, located near Newcastle. We have a state trooper with the Grady County Police, Greg Matthews, on the line with us from Tuttle, the location that was just recently hit by the second tornado not too long after. Greg, can you hear us?
Loud and clear, Glenn. I'm currently sheltered in my vehicle as there continues to be debris falling from the sky. The scene I am seeing here in Tuttle, it is as if a nuclear weapon went off and decimated everything in sight here. Foundations are completely scoured, roads have been wiped off the face of the earth, large trees have been uprooted with some branches destroying transformers in the area, causing power to be knocked out. Couple that with the debris blocking those roadways into and out of Tuttle, and these conditions have hindered federal emergency services in their attempts to reach the ground zero. Federal officers in Grady County have also reported that the southern portion of Minco was completely wiped off the face of the county as a result of this large tornado as well. The scene is just...
Tornado emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, northern Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Canadian County in central Oklahoma, northwestern McLean County in central Oklahoma, until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 3:01 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado with a history of cataclysmic damage was observed near Tuttle, or 10 miles northwest of Newcastle, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Seek an underground shelter immediately. Expected hazards include an extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado. The tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. At 2:54 p.m., a mobile Doppler radar site near Minco estimated wind speeds to be greater than 300 miles per hour before being knocked offline by the tornado. At 2:58 p.m., numerous reports of power poles snapped, areas of large debris blocking roadways, and extensive power outages were reported in Minco. Injuries, fatalities, and scoured foundations have been reported in Minco, Tuttle, and Gracemont, with an extended history of damage as far west as Carnegie. In addition, another tornado with its own history of catastrophic to apocalyptic devastation is on the direct path towards Oklahoma City, prompting a tornado emergency for the northern portion of the metro. Residents in the Oklahoma City metro, regardless of where you are, should immediately seek an underground shelter. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed.
Considering the imminent threat, I think it's in the best interest to ask that all non-essential personnel head to the underground shelter in the studio, as these tornadoes have the potential to scour foundations off the face of the planet. Power flashes have been reported as the tornado was making a beeline directly for Moore. Wait a minute. We just got a shot from the news chopper before it was forced to evacuate to a safer location. The shot it got looks pretty grim, but I will try to describe it in the best way possible. This tornado was reported to be lofting debris from a concrete building. This isn't El Reno 2.0, folks. It's so much worse.
I'm just looking further at this bulletin. Oh my god. This situation unfolding before us is being called a likely mass casualty situation. Everywhere east of the Canadian-Oklahoma county line need to seek immediate shelter now.
Oh dear god. Folks, he's right. There is wording in this bulletin That is exceedingly rare. And from the looks of it, said bulletin is advising all emergency services in the Oklahoma City Metro to prepare for, and I quote, a large-scale operation for search, rescue, and recovery. This is a tornado emergency for all of the Oklahoma City Metro, regardless of where you are. We have another meteorologist tracking this storm in a vehicle not too far out from the tornado. Richard, what's the situation at the moment?
Well, I'm continuing to track this monster making a direct approach to Oklahoma City. I have had to exercise caution as there have been reports of large debris being wafted from as far west as Clinton to just now in El Reno. Areas east of El Reno need to get to shelter. Oh my God!
Richard? Is everything all right?
Yeah, everything's fine. I just had a large piece of debris crash near my vehicle. This monster has been lifting things from as far west as Clinton, and based on recent reports, was observed lofting concrete and parts of asphalt into the sky, along with steel as well.
Wait a second.
Glenn, Charles, everyone back in the studio, I recommend that you seek immediate shelter now! I just heard the gander at the radar, and the tornado looks to be making a beeline towards downtown Oklahoma City.
You heard the man. From everyone at KOKC, if you have not done so, get to an underground shelter immediately to protect your life. In fact, considering the threat that this tornado poses, we are now going to be moving to our underground shelter. Let's go!
Everyone has a day!
Station KJY 94 in Chickasha, operating on a frequency of 162.450 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman.
Tornado emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, northern Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Canadian County in central Oklahoma, northwestern McLean County in central Oklahoma, until 3:45.
Oklahoma City metropolitan area. Widespread to devastate, damage expected. This is a life or death and likely mass casualty situation. A tornado warning remains in effect until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for Eastern Canadian and Central Oklahoma counties. At 3:10 p.m., an extremely large, incredibly violent, and destructive tornado was approaching the western section of the Oklahoma City metro area, moving east at 30 miles per hour. This is a life-threatening and likely cataclysmic, if not apocalyptic, situation. You can expect a deadly tornado. A tornado has been confirmed by local law enforcement, train weather spotters, and the public. At 3:08 p.m., reports of extreme destruction along with countless reports of life-threatening injuries and fatalities were coming in from areas previously affected by the tornado. In addition, it has been estimated that this tornado is nearly 3 miles wide, with winds confirmed to be over 300 miles per hour at this time. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. You will face almost certain death if not underground or in a tornado shelter. Mobile homes, buildings above ground, and vehicles will be decimated upon impact. Fire, medical, and police services are advised to be prepared for massive reports of severe to life-threatening injuries and for a large-scale operation of search, rescue, and recovery.
said services are also advised to gather backup from other areas in the state in anticipation of this unprecedented storm. Mass devastation has already occurred and will continue. Debris will block most, if not all, roadways. Power outages will be widespread, extensive, and lengthy in occurrence. Residents in these areas are urged to protect themselves in any manner from this tornado, which is expected to directly impact the downtown area in the next 10 to 15 minutes. Extreme to apocalyptic devastation has already been reported in El Reno. Again, residents in the Oklahoma City Metro should not delay, as any delay in time could result in your next stop being your last. This has been a severe weather statement from the National Weather Service. Tornado emergency for the Oklahoma City metropolitan area. Widespread to devastate, damage expected. This is a life or death and likely mass casualty situation. A tornado warning remains in effect until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight. Time could result in your next stop being your last. This has been a severe weather statement from the National Weather Service.
Tornado emergency for southern Oklahoma City and more. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for northeastern Grady County in central Oklahoma, southern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, northern Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Canadian County in central Oklahoma, northwestern McLean County in central Oklahoma, until 3...
For more. This is a life or death situation. A tornado warning remains in effect until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for southeastern Oklahoma and northeastern Cleveland counties. At 3:21 p.m., an unprecedented large and destructive tornado with a history of extensive, catastrophic devastation was located over Moore, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for more. This is a life or death situation. Seek an underground shelter now. You can expect an extremely dangerous and deadly tornado. Trained weather spotters and local law enforcement have confirmed a large wedge tornado with winds exceeding over 300 miles per hour as it crosses Interstate 35 south of Southwest 4th Street as this severe weather statement is being transmitted over the air. In addition, power flashes have been observed in the western section of Moore. At 3:20 p.m., a trained spotter reported that buildings in Minko and Tuttle were completely leveled, with foundations being scoured and roadways being shredded. The following impacts are expected. This is a life-threatening situation. You could be killed, if not underground, or in a tornado shelter. Complete destruction of entire neighborhoods is likely. Many well-built homes and businesses will be completely swept from their foundations. Debris will block most roadways. Mass devastation is highly likely, making the area unrecognizable to survivors. Mobile homes will be destroyed upon impact. In addition, fatalities have already been reported in Minko and Tuttle, with large debris signatures indicated not too long after this tornado impacted these areas. There were also some confirmed reports of injured people trapped in their underground shelters, with large chunks of debris blocking or even causing these shelters to completely collapse. Locations impacted include southeastern Oklahoma City, Norman, Moore, Midwest City, Dell City, Choctaw, Hera, Valley Brook, Stella, Tinker Air Force Base, Stanley Draper Lake, Northern Lake Thunderbird, and Little Axe. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. This tornado has the potential to cause mass casualties and extensive devastation across the emergency area. Do not wait to see, hear, or get confirmation of the tornado. Take action now to protect your life. This has been a severe weather statement from the National Weather Service. Tornado emergency for more. This is a life or death situation. A tornado warning remains in effect until 3:45 p.m. Central Daylight Time for southeastern Oklahoma and northeastern Cleveland counties. At 3:21 p.m., an unprecedented large and destructive tornado with a history of extensive, catastrophic devastation was located over Moore, moving east at 30 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Moore.
WNG654 near Stillwater, Oklahoma, operating on a frequency of 162.500 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman.
Tornado Watch number 115 remains in effect until midnight Central Daylight Time for the following counties in Oklahoma: Creek, Lincoln, Logan, Pawnee, and Payne. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Destructive, long-track tornadoes, large damaging hail up to grapefruit size, and extreme damaging winds are possible as severe thunderstorms track through central Oklahoma and western North Texas. Remember, a tornado watch means conditions are favorable for the development of severe weather, including tornadoes, large hail and damaging winds, in or close to the watch area. While severe weather may not be imminent, persons should remain alert for rapidly changing weather conditions and should listen for later statements and possible warnings. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio, commercial radio or television outlets and internet sources for the latest severe National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for eastern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, Lincoln County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Logan County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Payne County in central Oklahoma, northwestern Seminole County in east central Oklahoma, northeastern Cleveland County in central Oklahoma, northern Pottawatomie County in central Oklahoma, until 4:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 3:40 p.m. Central Daylight Time, two large and extremely dangerous tornadoes with a history of extensive to widespread devastation were continuing to be tracked by Doppler radar. One was located over Nuella, the other was located over Fallis. Both tornadoes were moving northeast at 30 miles per hour. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and grapefruit-size hail. A tornado has been confirmed by Doppler radar, storm spotters, emergency management, and the public. These tornadoes have a history of mass devastation in the Oklahoma City metro. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Cushing, Chandler, Stroud, Luther, Davenport, Wellston and Kearney, Tryon, Agra, Warwick, Kendrick, Fallis, Avery, Parkland, Shawnee, Choctaw, Hara, McLeod, Prague, Meeker, Johnson, Sparks, Dale, Niwala, Adelot and Centerview. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for eastern Oklahoma County in central Oklahoma, Lincoln County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Logan County in central Oklahoma, southeastern Payne County in central Oklahoma, northwestern. mobile home. We're in a vehicle. Move to the closest substantial shelter now. Get to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building and avoid windows. The normal broadcast schedule has been suspended because warnings have recently been issued for parts of your listening area. These warnings and statements will play next. Extremely dangerous tornado on ground near the Tarrant-Parker County line. Tornado emergency for Fort Worth and vicinity. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for East Central Parker County in North Central Texas, Central Tarrant County in North Central Texas, West Central Dallas County in North Central Texas, until 4:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 3:56 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a large and extremely dangerous tornado was observed over White Settlement, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Fort Worth and vicinity. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Source, radar and storm spotter confirmed large tornado converging on White Settlement. A large debris signature indicated by radar estimated the tornado to be around 2.4 miles wide in diameter. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near White Settlement now. River Oaks, Sansom Park, Lake Worth and West Worth Village around 4:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Edge Cliff around 4:10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Everman and Edge Cliff Village around 4:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Forest Hill around 4:20 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Richland Hills and Kendale around 4:25 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Arlington and Pentego around 4:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Westover Hills. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. extremely dangerous tornado on ground near the Tarrant-Parker County line. Tornado emergency for Fort Worth and vicinity. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for East Central Parker County in North Central Texas, Central Tarrant County in North Central Texas, West Central Dallas County in North Central Texas, until 4:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 3:56 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a large and extremely dangerous tornado was observed over White Settlement, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Fort Worth and vicinity. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado and hail 2 inches in diameter. Source, radar and storm spotter confirmed large tornado converging on White Settlement. A large debris signature indicated by radar estimated the tornado to be around 2.4 miles wide in diameter. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris may be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near White Settlement now. River Oaks, Sansom Park, Lake Worth and Westworth Village around 4:05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Edge Cliff around 4:10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Everman and Edge Cliff Village around 4:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Forest Hill around 4:20 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Richland Hills and Kendale around 4:25 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Arlington and Pantego around 4:30 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Other locations impacted by this tornadic thunderstorm include Westover Hills. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potential. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and grapefruit-sized hail. A tornado has been confirmed by Doppler radar, storm spotters, emergency. National Weather Service in Tulsa has issued a tornado warning for northwestern Creek County in northeastern Oklahoma, southwestern Pawnee County in northeastern Oklahoma, until 5:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 4:43 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and extremely dangerous tornado was located over Stillwater, moving northeast at 35 miles per hour. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Expected hazards included a damaging tornado and grapefruit-sized hail. A tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations in or near the path include Pawnee, Jennings and Meramec. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a basement or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If you are outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. western Noble County in northern Oklahoma, central Payne County in central Oklahoma, until 5:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 4:43 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado was observed over Stillwater, moving northeast at 35 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Stillwater. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Expected hazards include an extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado. A tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters. At 4:42 p.m., a trained spotter reported a large multivortex tornado near the South Duncan Street and Oklahoma State Route 51 intersection, moving slowly northeast. In addition, at 4:40 p.m., power flashes were observed as the tornado entered the southwest side of Stillwater. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. Locations impacted include Stillwater, Glencoe, and Ingalls. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to a storm shelter, safe room, or an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Tornado emergency for Stillwater. The National Weather Service in Norman has issued a tornado warning for southeastern Noble County in northern Oklahoma, central Payne County in central Oklahoma, until 5:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 4:43 p.m. Central Daylight Time, a confirmed large and destructive tornado was observed over Stillwater. You are listening to NOAA, All Hazards, the voice of the National Weather Service, station KEC 56, serving the Dallas-Fort Worth listening area. The following is a preliminary storm report. At 4:30 p.m., cataclysmic damage associated with a tornado was reported in Glen Rose. The following is a preliminary storm report. At 4:32 p.m., foundations were reported to be scoured in areas near Grand Prairie and Arlington. Tornado emergency for the eastern half of the Metroplex. The National Weather Service in Fort Worth has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Rockwall County in north central Texas, west central Kaufman County in north central Texas, east central Tarrant County in north central Texas, central Dallas County in north central Texas, until 5:15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 4:40 p.m. Central Daylight Time, an unprecedented large and extremely dangerous tornado was centered near Duncanville, or near Cockrell Hill, moving east at 35 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for the eastern half of the Metroplex. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Take cover now. Hazard, deadly tornado. Source, emergency management and storm spotters confirmed large, multi-vortex, wedge tornado, with a history of extensive to unprecedented devastation in the western half of the Metroplex, near Grand Prairie at 4:30 p.m. In addition, power flashes have been observed near Cockrell Hill and Duncanville as this tornado moves slowly east. Impact, you are in a life-threatening situation. Flying debris will be deadly to those caught without shelter. Mobile homes will be destroyed. Considerable damage to homes, businesses, and vehicles is likely and complete destruction is possible. The tornado will be near Duncanville and Cockrell Hill now. University Park in Highland Park around 4:50 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Hutchins around 5 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Belch Springs around 5.05 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Mesquite around 5.10 p.m. Central Daylight Time. Shagoville, Forney, Heath and Sunnyvale around 5.15 p.m. Central Daylight Time. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Outdoors, in a mobile home, or in a vehicle, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-27 in Tulsa. These broadcasts originate from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Tulsa. Transmitting facilities are located in northeast Oklahoma and serve metropolitan Tulsa and surrounding areas. Tornado Watch number 115 continues until midnight Central Daylight Time for the following counties in the listening area. In Arkansas, Benton, Carroll, Crawford, Franklin, Logan, Madison, Scott, Sebastian, and Washington. In Missouri, Barry and McDonald. In Oklahoma, Adair, Atoka, Bryan, Cherokee, Choctaw, Cole, Craig, Creek, Delaware, Haskell, Hughes, Kay, Latimer, LaFleur, Mays, McIntosh, Muskogee, Noble, Nuada, Okfusgee, Okmulgee, Osage, Ottawa, Pawnee, Payne, Pittsburgh, Pushmataha, Rogers, Seminole, Sequoia, Tulsa, Wagoner, and Washington. This is a particularly dangerous situation. Devastating to unprecedented damage expected, tornado emergency for Tulsa. The National Weather Service in Tulsa has issued a tornado warning for southwestern Rogers County in northeastern Oklahoma, southeastern Osage County in northeastern Oklahoma, eastern Creek County in northeastern Oklahoma, southern Washington County in northeastern Oklahoma, northwestern Wagoner County in northeastern Oklahoma, southeastern Pawnee County in northeastern Oklahoma, northwestern Okmulgee County in northeastern Oklahoma, Tulsa County in northeastern Oklahoma, until 6 p.m. Central Daylight Time. At 5.04 p.m. Central Daylight Time, two confirmed historic large and destructive tornadoes with an extensive history of catastrophic to apocalyptic damage were continuing to be tracked by Doppler radar, located 6 miles south of Bristol and near Drum Right, or near Tulsa, moving northeast at 35 miles per hour. Tornado emergency for Tulsa. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation. Seek an underground shelter immediately to protect your life. Expected hazards include an extremely dangerous and potentially deadly tornado. A tornado has been confirmed by trained weather spotters and local law enforcement. These tornadoes have an extensive history of producing cataclysmic to apocalyptic damage in Oklahoma City and the surrounding metro. In addition, a mobile Doppler on wheels near Sepulpa, in addition to a mobile Doppler radar site near Bristow, has indicated wind speeds in excess of 300 miles per hour as these two unprecedented tornadoes continue to track northeastward towards the city of Tulsa. scoured foundations, concrete and steel being lifted, and mangled power lines have been reported as these tornadoes tracked through Lincoln, Okmulgee, Seminole, and Pottawatomie counties. Residents in Tulsa, regardless of where your present location is, should seek an immediate underground shelter now. The following impacts are expected. You are in a life-threatening situation. You will face almost certain death if struck by flying debris. Mobile homes and buildings above ground will offer no protection. Extensive damage to buildings, if not complete destruction, will occur. Extensive power outages will be likely. Mass devastation will almost be certain, rendering the area unrecognizable to survivors. Locations in or near the path include Tulsa, Broken Arrow, Sand Springs, Owosso, Bixby, Sepulpa, Jenks, Glenpool, Coweta, Skyatook, Catoosa, Collinsville, Verdigris, Manford, Kiefer, Sperry, Mounds, Kellyville, Slick and Jenks Riverside Airport. To repeat, a large, extremely dangerous, and potentially deadly tornado is on the ground. To protect your life, take cover now. Move to an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows. If in a mobile home, a vehicle, or outdoors, move to the closest substantial shelter and protect yourself from flying debris. A large and extremely dangerous tornado is on the ground. Take immediate tornado precautions. This is an emergency situation. Devastating to unprecedented damage expected, tornado emergency for Tulsa. The National Weather Service in Tulsa has issued a tornado warning for
Guard or proper authorities. This station will go off the air until further information is received.
For now, continue monitoring local media outlets for the latest information.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Oklahoma Emergency Management Agency. A state of emergency is in effect for western, central, and northeastern Oklahoma due to severe weather that occurred in the area earlier today. Mass devastation due to large multi-vortex tornadoes has been reported in the following locations: Clinton, Moore, Oklahoma City, Stillwater, and Tulsa. Buildings in these areas are reported to be completely defoliated, with some suffering total collapse. Roads in these areas are completely blocked, if not collapsed, as a result of large debris, with some areas in these localities reporting asphalt torn from the foundation entirely. If you are in the worst hit areas and require assistance, emergency services will not be able to reach you. In addition, there are reports of residents trapped in their underground shelters. If you require assistance, do not dial 911. Leave the lines open for official use only. The Oklahoma National Guard is currently on site to assist those affected in Oklahoma City and Moore, and is en route to assist those affected in Clinton, Stillwater, and Tulsa. If you live outside the warned areas, do not assist the areas affected until the situation is further assessed by the National Guard or is given the all clear by the proper authorities. This station will now go off the air until further information is received. For now, continue monitoring local media outlets for the latest information.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Dallas and Tarrant County Emergency Management. Complete the total destruction, if it can even be called that, has been reported in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex as the result of a large multi-vortex tornado earlier today.
Building in the majority of downtown Dallas and downtown Fort Worth have been reported to have vanished off the face of the earth due to the sheer power of this tornado. Power outages are widespread in the Metroplex, further complicating emergency services in the area, with power poles being snapped or in the worst hit areas non-existent. In addition, shelters have been reported to be completely decimated above or underground due to a large amount of reported ground scouring in portions of the Metroplex. At this time, a massive search and recovery effort is underway in the Metroplex, including areas near Glen Rose, where the Comanche Peak nuclear power plant came dangerously close to being struck by another tornado that was to the south of this tornado. It is currently unknown if any radiological hazards exist at the present moment. If it can even be described as such, the worst hit areas were wiped off the map to the point where civilization never existed to begin with. Any further information is being withheld at this time until the situation is further assessed as efforts in search and recovery continue. The station will be going off the air until further notice to conserve whatever power it has left. At this time, tune to a local radio station for further information on this situation.
Tornado that tore through the metropolitan area. At this time, most buildings have been reduced to near nothing, along with vehicles, homes, and infrastructure in the area. Ground scouring has also been reported, along with sections of roads missing in visible dents in the soil. A majority of the city is also without power, as a number of power poles and electrical lines have simply vanished from existence. The damage, if it can be called that, can be described as unsurvivable if shelters were not underground, though countless parts of those trapped in storm cellars have also come in. Those left alive are advised to wait for help from emergency officials. Do not exit for any reason, even if you are not blocked from doing so by debris. It is unknown how long it will take until full rescue efforts are complete before search and recovery operations begin. Stay tuned to this NOAA weather radio station or other media outlets. Being transmitted at the request of the Cleveland County Emergency Management Agency and the Oklahoma State Police. A devastating event has occurred to the former cities of Moore and Bridge Creek, Oklahoma. After an unprecedented, frighteningly destructive, and large tornado ripped through both areas, it was discovered that both areas suffered total annihilation to the point of being wiped off the map. There is no infrastructure left standing. Most, if not all, power poles have been torn from the ground. Only small sections of roads remain, with others ripped apart and craters have been dug into the soil from this monstrous storm. Probably most horrific of all, any underground shelters in both locations have either given way or have been horrifically damaged, and at this time the number of survivors is unknown. Emergency officials are calling both areas total losses, and a widespread search, rescue, and recovery effort is underway in both areas. No further information has been given or released at this time until the situation is fully assessed. For the time being, stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio or any other media outlet as updates become readily available.
Messages transmitted at the request of the Tulsa County Emergency Management. Extensive, if not apocalyptic, decimation has been reported in the city of Tulsa due to two large, violent, multi-vortex tornadoes. Power lines have been reported snapped, with some completely non-existent, and some snapped, leading to extensive power outages in the metro. Buildings have suffered complete, if not total, defoliation as a result of not only damage from tornadoes, but damage from debris lofted by the tornadoes. In a manner similar to Oklahoma City and Stillwater, roadways have been completely disassembled to the point where only gravel, if not dirt, exists where they once were. Automobiles have been mangled and crushed beyond recognition, some to the point where anything was unrecognizable to begin with. In a disturbing sequence similar to Moore and Bridge Creek, some shelters have been reported swept away, regardless if they were above or underground, due to the sheer power of these tornadoes and extensive ground scouring outside of and in the city of Tulsa. Emergency management in Tulsa County and the surrounding vicinity are requesting that residents do not travel throughout the overnight hours. If you must travel, you do so at your own risk and avoid any areas, especially the worst-hit areas, as emergency services are already having a difficult time reaching the people affected. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio or your local media outlets for the latest information on this dangerous situation.
This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH 27 in Tulsa. These broadcasts originate from the National Weather Service. You are listening to NOAA, All Hazards, the voice of the National Weather Service, Station KEC 56, serving the Dallas-Fort Worth listening area. The following is a storm survey report. A line of thunderstorms was first noted to have developed west of the Texas-New Mexico border, mainly near locations in Albuquerque, New Mexico, at around 11 a.m. Central Daylight Time, prompting severe thunderstorm watches to be issued for the area. However, as these storms tracked eastward, they began to move into an environment considered exceptionally favorable for the development of strong, long-track tornadoes. These conditions prompted a tornado watch to be issued for portions of the Texas Panhandle and Oklahoma Panhandle. Eventually, the first tornado warnings would be issued at around 12:13 p.m. Central Daylight Time for areas in western Oklahoma. However, this would only mark the beginning of a day that would be etched into the history books. Not too long after, another tornado watch would be issued for northern Texas and central and eastern Oklahoma. The first notable long-track tornado would occur in the vicinity of Lubbock. As this line of storms progressed, tornado warnings, and, Eventually, tornado emergencies would be issued for portions of our county warning area, particularly around the Dallas-Fort Worth area. The following survey contains information specific to the Stevensville, Glen Rose, Rio Vista Tornado, and the Dallas-Fort Worth Tornado. It was determined that the Glen Rose Tornado initially began life as a small, rope-shaped tornado a few miles west of Stevensville, beginning rapid intensification after impacting Stevensville. A low was then encountered, before rapid intensification ensued once again just west of Glen Rose. Extensive to extreme amounts of devastation were reported as the tornado proceeded to level the city of Glen Rose. This includes, but is not limited to, the following information. Asphalt from roadways was completely scoured in a manner similar to the Jarrell 1997 tornado. Buildings and vehicles were left completely decimated beyond recognition, some buildings to the point of total collapse. Large swaths of ground scouring occurred west and east of town, with the worst hit area being the downtown district. Large chunks of debris have almost cut off all roadways going into and exiting Glen Rose, as if contact was nearly lost at ground zero. Rio Vista also sustained a catastrophic hit as well, with damage reported on the western section of town, before the tornado dissipated east of the city. It was determined that the Dallas-Fort Worth tornado began life west of Weatherford, rapidly intensifying into a wedge just west of White Settlement. What would happen next is, in a sense, disturbing to say the least. White Settlement would be wiped off the face of the earth, with areas completely unrecognizable to survivors. The tornado would then proceed to cause extensive to cataclysmic devastation in the city of Fort Worth. More specifically, the following information was reported on a survey regarding damage from the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. A large debris signature was indicated, with multiple vortices reported by Doppler radar as this tornado tracked through the Metroplex, with the worst hit areas being described as inaccessible to even emergency services. Concrete has been scoured about, blocking a large majority of roadways entering and exiting the Metroplex, with some instances of bridges collapsing as a result of the large debris. A Doppler on wheels managed to observe briefly a peak speed of 305 miles per hour as this tornado slowly moved eastward across the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex in a manner similar to the 1997 Jarrell tornado. A significant number of injuries and fatalities were reported in Dallas-Fort Worth due to the extreme amounts of devastation caused by this tornado. In the worst hit areas, foundations were completely scoured to the point where complete destruction occurred only seconds after being lifted from the ground, in addition to asphalt being scoured from roadways, trees being snapped and completely uprooted, with some areas of these trees being completely unrecognizable. This tornado would also directly impact the cities of Midland and Chisholm and Heath, leaving damage that could only be described as cataclysmic. In conclusion, the last rating of an F5, or an EF5, in our county warning area was Waco of 1953. For the first time since then, based on the extreme amounts of destruction that could only be described as unprecedented, the National Weather Service has given both tornadoes a preliminary rating of EF5. These tornadoes, along with the tornadoes that struck Wichita Falls, Texas and Lubbock, Texas earlier that afternoon, are the first EF5 tornadoes to strike the state since Jarrell of 1997. The following reports of weather temperature and wind were taken at noon. This is your weather radio station WXK85 in Oklahoma City, operating on a frequency of 162.40 MHz. Programming originates from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Norman, Oklahoma. This is a storm survey report regarding information gathered from severe weather that affected the area on May 20, 2019. A line of thunderstorms was first noted to have developed west of the Texas-New Mexico border, mainly near locations in Albuquerque, New Mexico, at around 11 a.m. Central Daylight Time, prompting severe thunderstorm watches to be issued for the area. However, as these storms tracked eastward, they began to move into an environment considered exceptionally favorable for the development of strong, long-track tornadoes. These conditions prompted a tornado watch to be issued for portions of the Texas Panhandle and Oklahoma Panhandle.
Eventually, the first tornado warnings would be issued at around 12:13 p.m. Central Daylight Time for areas in western Oklahoma. However, this would only mark the beginning of a day that would be etched into the history books. Not too long after, another tornado watch would be issued for northern Texas and central and eastern Oklahoma. The first notable long-track tornado would occur in the vicinity of Lubbock. As this line of storms progressed, tornado warnings, and, eventually, tornado emergencies would be issued for portions of our county warning area, particularly around Wichita Falls, Oklahoma City, and more. The National Weather Service has conducted storm damage assessments along a swath from Wichita Falls to Clinton to Oklahoma City to the eastern end of our county warning area within the past 2 days, and has gathered the following information. The tornado that impacted Oklahoma City first formed into a rope-shaped tornado north of Cedar Lake from the same line that produced the Clinton tornado, wobbling east-northeast and east-southeast before impacting the city of El Reno at wind speeds of 295 miles per hour. Intensification was not over yet, however, as peak wind speeds would occur as it directly struck the northern suburbs of Oklahoma City and the downtown district with wind speeds of 310 miles per hour. A few miles per hour shy of the 1999 Bridge Creek Moor tornado. Southern Edmond and Arcadia were also leveled. The tornado that would directly impact the city of Moor would begin life southwest of Coger, with tree damage noted as the tornado tracked east. Intensification would ensue before the tornado struck the city of Minco, leveling, if not completely destroying, buildings in the area. The next city in the path of this tornado, Tuttle, was observed to be completely unrecognizable to survivors. The next area of damage would be where the tornado reached peak wind speeds, eclipsing the wind speed measured during the 1999 Bridge Creek Moor tornado. The wind speeds indicated were at around 325 miles per hour, 7 miles per hour above 318, the estimated maximum wind speed of the 1999 Bridge Creek Moor tornado. The tornado that would impact Wichita Falls would begin life as a small, rope-shaped tornado, north of Lake Diversion, before rapidly intensifying into a large tornado, before completely leveling the city of Kamar, Texas. Intensification did not end there, as another period of rapid intensification was indicated, with a large debris signature indicated in southern Wichita Falls, and several spotter reports of a tornado, estimated by trained weather spotters to be 2.5 miles wide in diameter. In Clinton, the following information was gathered. Buildings were reported to be swept away from their foundations, if not completely destroyed. Ground scourings were observed east of town as a tornado caused extensive damage to the area. Steel-reinforced foundations were observed to have suffered complete defoliation, to the point of total collapse in the area. The tornado was determined to have lasted on the ground from as far west as Elk City, rapidly intensifying to its peak strength just west of Clinton, proceeding to dissect the city from west to east. The tornado would dissipate after impacting the city of Hydro. In Oklahoma City and Moore, the following information was gathered. In both areas, foundations were noted to have been completely destroyed. Concrete block and high-rise apartments were reported to have swayed dangerously to the point of total collapse. Large debris essentially cut off any contact with a majority of the ground zero of impact in both locations, hindering any assistance that would be provided by emergency services. Ground scouring was reported west of Moor and east of Oklahoma City. Most disturbingly, the entire city of Moor looked as if civilization never existed. In Wichita Falls, the following information was gathered. Damage was reported in Wichita Falls, in a manner similar to the Wichita Falls tornado of 1964. The southern portion of Wichita Falls had suffered the worst devastation, with considerable damage to homes and businesses reported in the downtown district. In fact, some homes were completely destroyed as a result of the sheer power of this tornado in the worst-hit areas. Some ground scouring was reported to have occurred to the southwest of Wichita Falls before the tornado proceeded to mangle cars and power lines in the southern portion of town. The last time a rating of EF5 was given by this exact forecast office 6 years prior on this exact day, May 20th. That is, until now. All four tornadoes have received the following preliminary rating. The tornado that struck Moore has been given a rating of a high in EF5, based on the extreme amounts of devastation in both areas. This is the first EF5 rating anywhere since May 20, 2013, which makes this tornado even more eerily ironic, having struck the city of Moore 6 years later. The tornado that struck Oklahoma City, most particularly near areas in northern Oklahoma City, El Reno, and Edmond, a preliminary EF5 rating has been given. Damage in El Reno is considered ironic, as the last time an EF5 struck the city was nearly 8 years ago. A rating of a high in EF5 was also given to the tornado that struck Clinton due to the sheer force of the wind speeds as they impacted the northern sections of the area in a manner similar to El Reno of 2011 and El Reno of 2013. And, finally, for the first time since Jarrell of 1997, the National Weather Service has given a preliminary rating of EF5 to the tornado that struck Wichita Falls, Texas. This marks the first EF5 to strike anywhere in Texas in nearly 22 years. You are listening to Oklahoma City Weather Radio, and here are noon weather observations. And Oklahoma City. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station KIH-27 in Tulsa. These broadcasts originate from the National Weather Service Forecast Office in Tulsa. Transmitting facilities are located in northeast Oklahoma and serve metropolitan Tulsa and surrounding areas. This is a public information statement issued by the National Weather Service in Tulsa. The following statement contains information from a storm survey conducted in conjunction with the National Weather Service in Norman. A line of thunderstorms was first noted to have developed west of the Texas-New Mexico border, mainly near locations in Albuquerque, New Mexico, at around 11 a.m. Central Daylight Time, prompting severe thunderstorm watches to be issued for the area. However, as these storms tracked eastward, they began to move into an environment considered exceptionally favorable for the development of strong, long-track tornadoes. These conditions prompted a tornado watch to be issued for portions of the Texas Panhandle and Oklahoma Panhandle. Eventually, the first tornado warnings would be issued at around 12:13 p.m. Central Daylight Time for areas in western Oklahoma. However, this would only mark the beginning of a day that would be etched into the history books. The first notable long-track tornado would occur in the vicinity of Lubbock, Texas. Two tornadoes that would begin life in Norman's County warning area would track in from Lincoln County, Oklahoma, having struck the Oklahoma City Metro not too long before entering our county warning area. These tornadoes caused significant damage in the Tulsa metropolitan area, with reports of massive casualties, injuries, and damage. Trained weather spotters have described the area as completely decimated. Many well-constructed buildings in the area were completely swept away from their foundations. Power lines and many trees had been uprooted, broken, and snapped. Fires have also resulted due to leaking gas from many areas in the downtown core being ignited by sparks caused by damaged transformers and power poles. Automobiles have been crushed beyond their limits. Some reports have also stated that some of the automobiles destroyed by the tornado were completely twisted open due to the sheer power from the tornado. The most disturbing of damage occurred when surveys found that ground scouring of 25 feet occurred in the heart of Tulsa from the second tornado, with ground scourings of 20 feet occurring in northern Tulsa, with shelters both above and underground having suffered extreme damage in the process. In the heart of Tulsa, buildings, shelters above and underground, automobiles and power poles were also reported to have completely vanished, as if they never existed to begin with. To conclude, these two tornadoes lifted near the Rogers-Mays County line, but not before scouring further ground near the Tulsa-Rogers and Tulsa-Waggoner County lines. Before the discussion of this survey is concluded, a final rating of both tornadoes has been given. The tornado that struck northern Tulsa has been given a rating of EF5, based on extreme amounts of damage, if it can even be called that, as areas in northern Tulsa were observed to be reduced to concrete slabs, if not having completely vanished without a trace. The tornado that caused mass devastation in the southern half of Tulsa, including downtown, has been given a rating of EF5, due to extreme amounts of damage and ground scourings that occurred in downtown Tulsa, including multiple buildings, power poles, vehicles, and roadways vanishing without a trace. These are the first EF5 tornadoes to strike anywhere in northeastern Oklahoma since 1960. Stay tuned to NOAA Weather Radio or your favorite source for the latest information. The forecast for the Tulsa area, including much of northeast Oklahoma.